Hello there guys. I hope you all are safe and sound in the comforts of your homes. I know you all are itching to go out there and play your favorite sport or watch someone play. The closure of sporting facilities and training grounds has forced us to train and work out at home. You may be having a number of questions in your mind, such as what aspects of training to focus on, whether that attractive workout that you saw yesterday on the net is good for you, and so on. So here we are. Today, me, Dr. Mamta Rewankar, sports physiotherapist, will give you 5 essential tips to make your exercise or workout at home effective. And so let's dive into it. Tip number 1, train optimally. Even if you are cooped up at home, it doesn't mean you shouldn't train the way you did earlier. Stoppage of training can lead to drastic reductions in your maximal oxygen consumption, on your heart rate, on your cardiac output, muscle mass, and so on. If you reduce training frequency and volume, it's allowed, but if you reduce intensity, it will be bad. So maintain a high intensity. Incorporate HIIT into your routine, that is working at near maximal or maximal intensities for a shorter duration. Use workers to rest ratios which are higher if you are an endurance athlete and lower ratios if you are a strength athlete. But maintain good rest and adequate rest in between the sessions so that you do not undergo overtraining. Overtraining can lead to infections and reduce your immunity, so take care about that. Tip number 2. Be creative. Although the lack of space or lack of equipment in your houses may pose a problem and you may not be able to work on strength the way you did earlier, there are various other ways to maintain muscle mass even if you do not have those heavy equipment, because muscle mass is what will ultimately translate into good and a very strong force production. One way of doing this is by increasing your number of reps with the muscle going into failure. So that will help in maintaining that muscle mass and improving the force production. Another way that you can do this is by using your body weight optimally. You can do a Bulgarian squat by using your body weight and keeping that leg on a chair or a sofa. Increase the load by having a child or a pet in your hand or a water bottle in your hand. You can do a pull-up by using trousers on either sides of the door, which is locked, to keep it fixed and then pull yourself up. So you have a million ways that you can use to work out at home optimally. Tip number 3, focus on accessory aspects. So focus on adjunct areas of your sport like core, balance, mobility, injury resilience. Now is the time to do that. So say you are a swimmer, you can work on your shoulder because we know shoulder injuries are more prone in swimmers. So work on that shoulder, do rotator cuff exercises or scapula exercises to make your shoulder bulletproof. If you speak of core, then unless you are injured, planks are not a good idea. Incorporate trunk rotations, say pull up press exercises or a farmer's walk with weights on either hands if you want to target that core. If you talk of balance, then you can use the ball vault dribbles standing on one leg or with your eyes closed. Stretch so that you work on your mobility, because you do not require gym equipment or gym premises for that. Tip number 4, use internet resources judiciously. While surfing the internet, you may have seen that the internet is teeming with people giving out workout videos that are appealing and very creative and exciting. However, consult your physio, S&C or coach before indulging in them, because your protocols that have been made for you are specific for your sport. Tip number 5 and the final tip is to maintain good communication and contact with your team and your health personnel. Maybe attending team meetings on video call would be a good idea to boost morale, to discuss tactical aspects of the game, to delve on past achievements so that you feel good about yourself. Also, fill in those athlete monitoring systems so that your physio, your S&C, your coach have an idea of what you did during this lockdown period so that they can make an appropriate program when you get back to it by screening you accordingly. So, there you go. The last and final message that I want to put across is, most importantly, practice social distancing and good hand hygiene. Stay at home, Also, stay hydrated, eat well, and get adequate sleep so that when you get back into the game, you are at your fullest and you are at your strongest level. Thank you.